Our struggle is not against flesh and blood. It's against the powers of this dark world. I'm a soldier. Therefore, put on the full armor of God. I'm a soldier. So you can stand your ground.
I'm a soldier. Clothes on
in the army.
I got my war clothes on
in the army of the Lord.
I got my war clothes on.
Good morning, children. Happy, happy Sunday. How are you all doing today? I'm sure you've been having a wonderful time in school, and very soon you're going to go on holidays. That's exciting, isn't it? All right. Okay, this morning we're going to go straight into our topic for today, and we are looking at our last confession in our confession series, which is I am a soldier in the Lord's army. I'm Auntie Shadi, and I'm so happy to be here with you this morning. Okay, quickly, let's go into our identity confession. Are you guys ready? Okay, let's go. I am wonderfully made. I am fearfully made. I am a child of God. I am not a slave to fear. I know my identity. I am bold. I am a soldier in the Lord's army. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. And I am creative and full of ideas. You can say them as often as you like. And as you say them, believe them in your heart. Awesome. Now, last week, we learned on our identity, which declares, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. And what did we learn? We learned that God has a mission for everyone, and even this mission has been before we were born. God has equipped us with all that we need to be able to fulfill our mission. God knows that we cannot be all that we want to be in our own strength. So he has given us the Holy Spirit to live in us and help us in all that we do. When we pray to God and ask for his help, he strengthens us and enables us to achieve what may seem impossible. And we looked at Philippians 4:13 that says, we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. Now today, we are looking at our last confession. I am a soldier in the Lord's army. This is our final identity declaration. Okay? Now, let's look closely. Who is a soldier? A soldier is a man or woman who fights for their country, risking their lives in the process. What is an army? An army is an organized military force equipped for fighting on land. Every army is led by a commander. Now, what does it mean to be in the Lord's army? Every Christian is called to be a soldier in the army of God. Soldiers are called to encounter evil or oppose evil forces. A Christian soldier must know what the commander, who is God, wants, and he must live by the Spirit. Now, do you remember a while ago we taught you about the armor of God in Ephesians chapter 6, verses 13 to 26? You remember? Wonderful. Now, an armor is what a soldier or warrior wears or put on to go into battle. How many can you remember? Let's take a quick look. The Christian warrior. He has the helmet of salvation. Yes, on his head, which is the foundation of which the warrior stands. Then he has the sword of the Spirit, which is used to attack his enemies when he is at war. And that sword is the word of God. Then look closely, we have the belt of truth. This stands for firm belief in the word of God. Then we have the breastplate of righteousness. This is to protect the warrior from the evils of this world. Then we have the shield of faith to extinguish the arrows of the evil one. And finally, we have the sandals of righteousness, which is to live a righteous life for other people to follow. Wonderful. Now you guys remember. Now, did you know that the character of a soldier is also very important? Let's look at this. A good soldier is unique and set apart, wonderfully and fearfully made. A good soldier knows who he or she is, knows his or her identity as a child of God. A good soldier has faith to face any attack. He or she is bold. A good soldier is a problem solver. He or she is creative and full of ideas. Wonderful. A good soldier is not held back by any fear. He or she is not a slave to fear. A good soldier calls on God in prayer for help to achieve his or her mission, and thereby can do all things through Christ. Now, did you know of any good soldiers around you? Look around. Do you see any? Do you see an army? Okay, today we are going to read a story about a man named Gideon in the Bible. And this story can be found in the book of Judges, chapter 7 and 8. Now, there was a man named Gideon who was a farmer. An angel came to Gideon and announced that God was going to use him to save the people and destroy their enemies, the Midianites. Gideon was doubtful. He was not mighty or powerful or a strong soldier. How could God use him? But the angel assured him that he was the man for the job. Gideon was instructed to tear down the idols of the false god, Baal. He took them out of the temple and replaced them with God's altar. Fantastic. Even after doing this, Gideon was still full of doubt. Gideon asked God to give him a special sign, just to make sure he really was the one God wanted to use to defeat the Midianites. God gave him the signs he asked for. When it was time to prepare for battle, God told Gideon that there were too many people with him, too many. Then God asked him to reduce the number of the people by asking those who were afraid to go back home. Some people left, but God said there were still too many. So he asked Gideon to tell the men to go to the river to drink water. Those who put their mouth into the water were to be sent back home, while those who used their hands to cup the water to their lips were to stay. When this was done, the number of people remaining to fight was quite little, only 300 men, especially when you compare this number to those they were going to fight against, who were numbered in thousands. Do you know why God did this? God wanted to make sure he received the glory for the victory. The Israelites had to know there was no possible way they could have done it on their own. So, Gideon put his faith in God and believed in God's promise. He divided the 300 men into three, and he put trumpets into the hands of all of them and empty jars with torches inside the jars. He instructed the men to follow his lead. Gideon led the men to the outskirts of the camps of the Midianites, and then he took his trumpet and he blew it. They did likewise, shouting, "For the Lord and for Gideon! For the Lord and for Gideon!" Then they smashed the jars with the torches inside. Do you know what happened? The army of the Midianites fled. They ran away from the Israelites. The Israelites didn't even have to fight. All they had to do was blow their trumpets and smash their pitchers to reveal the torches inside. And as soon as they started, the army of the Midian ran away. Enemies ran away and they started fighting amongst themselves. Wow! God did it! He won with Gideon's help, just as he had promised. Wonderful! Now, we are going to do a short recap of the identity series. We have learned over the last few weeks what our identity is and who God says we are. Let's do a quick recap. I am wonderfully made. And this means we are all unique and special. Even when we look alike, we are not the same. All right? I am fearfully made. We are God's beautiful masterpiece. I know my identity. I am a child of God. Your identity is who you truly are. You are a child of God. You have been adopted into God's family. And you are loved just like God loves Jesus. I am bold. We are full of courage and stand for what is right always. I am creative and full of ideas. Our gifts and talents comes from God, and we are all creative because we are made in God's image. I am not a slave to fear. We do not have to be afraid of whatever may come because we know that God is on our side. Wonderful. God has given us everything we need to be soldiers in his army, and we are fully equipped to fight off the devil's evil plans and temptation. God is our commander, and he has given us three main ways to know what he wants of us. Number one, his master plan is the Bible. So God expects us to read our Bibles every time, daily. Second, the Holy Spirit to guide us. God has given us the Holy Spirit to guide us. So we must learn to trust in the Holy Spirit as he guides us. And thirdly, prayer. We pray to communicate with God every day. And this is so, so important, because God wants to hear you when you pray, and he wants to answer your prayer. Wonderful, wonderful. Now we are going to look at our memory verse. Our memory verse today is taken from 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 3. And we are looking at the TPT version. The TPT is the Passion Translation. Okay, guys? So go and check it out. Let's go. The memory verse says, overcome every form of evil as a victorious soldier of Jesus, the Anointed One. And this can be found in 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 3. Let us pray. Dear God, thank you for this day and for my life. Thank you because I am your child, and you have given me everything I need to fight off the devil's evil plan. Thank you because I know who I am in you, and you will always continue to help me to obey and meditate in your word. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen.
Slapstick Theater. Gideon's 300 Men. This is Gideon.
Hey!
Who was a judge of Israel. In the time when Gideon lived, a group of people called the Midianites were taking over the Israelites' land.
Get out of here!
And the Israelites were starving. So the Israelites asked God for help. God chose Gideon to rescue the Israelites.
Hey, everybody!
And gave him the power to lead an army of Israelites.
Yeah!
One day, Gideon and his army got up early and came close to the Midianite camp. God told Gideon that he had too many warriors with him.
Really?
So God told Gideon to let all the men who were scared go home.
All right, you can go home.
Phew.
So 22,000 men went home, and Gideon was left with only 10,000. But God told Gideon that he still had too many men with him.
What, really?
He told Gideon to bring the men down to the water, and that God would give them a test.
Okay.
Gideon did as God asked, and then God said, divide the men in two groups. In one group, put all those who cup water in their hands and lap it up with their tongues like dogs. In the other group, put those who kneel down and drink with their mouths in the stream. Only 300 men drank from their hands. God told Gideon, with these 300 men, I will rescue you and give you victory over the Midianites. Send all the others home. So Gideon did as God said.
You can go home.
That night, God told Gideon to get up and go down to the camp to listen to what the Midianites were saying.
Hey, Pura, let's go!
Gideon and his servant Pura went down to the camp and saw the huge army. There were too many men and camels for Gideon to even count.
Whoa, that's a lot of camels.
But Gideon heard a soldier telling another man about a dream he had that showed them that God would give Gideon victory over the Midianites. When Gideon heard this, he worshipped God.
Come on!
Then Gideon and his army of 300 men went down to the Midianite camp. They blew their horns and held torches in their hands. They yelled out, and the Midianite soldiers rushed around in a panic and tried to escape. Then God caused the Midianites to start fighting against each other. Because of God's power, Gideon and his army had victory over the Midianites that day.